Woo! I've been out here a little too long. We got a chef to do. Now it's time to do the other guy. Wait. That's wrong choice of words. Let us begin anew, Mistress Waters. I am Sir Orterel de Fulton, eldest son of Court Edmund de Fulton. Ooh, that's a lot of strange words. You will forgive me my outburst, I hope. I meant no disrespect. I merely consider myself equal to the duties entrusted to me, unlike some. Orchefon has spoken of you often. If you are even half the woman he claims, I shall be glad to have you at my side. To the matter at hand, then. We will be assisting my esteemed compatriots of houses Durandal and Zemel. I have no idea about the pronunciations. There's so many ways to say it. You are aware of our friendly rivalry, I take it? Aye. Well, suffice it to say, the prospect of assisting said houses does not fill me with joy. However, it is the will of the Holy See that we set aside our differences at this crucial juncture. But we shall speak more of that anon. First, we must need secure transport to Falcon's Nest. Let us make for the Chocobo Stables and Foundation. As long as I don't have to claim them. Greetings, Mistress Waters. I saddled a black Chocobo for your journey to the Western Highlands, as per Lord Orterell's instruction. Will this be your first time riding a black Chocobo, may I ask? If so, you're in for a treat. As I dare say you know, this particular breed can fly. Given the right conditions, they can carry you quite high too, even our snow cloak. You needn't worry about directing the bird, of course. Like all porters, she's trained to carry you to your destination all by herself. So just relax and enjoy the view. Oh, but be sure not to relax your grip, will ya? Two hands on the reins at all times, if you please.
To the frozen wastes of the Western Highlands, once verdant tracts made pallid by the calamity. Beyond the towering wall of ice, to lands long forsaken that the knights of Ishgard strove tirelessly to reclaim. To the hamlet of Falcon's Nest. Once abandoned, now freed of its pall of snow and ash, she came.
The world looks quite different when viewed from the back of an airborne chocobo, does it not? I still find the experience strangely liberating. To business. Sir Redwald is in charge here. He should be expecting us. It has been far, far too long, Lord Orterel. And who might your companion be? Pray forgive us our lateness, Sir Redwald. I present to you Delora Waters, ward of House Fortom. Ah, yes, of course. Lord Drillamont spoke of you. I, Sir Redwald of House Durandale, do bid you welcome to Falcon's Nest. We are both eager to contribute to the settlement's restoration. How may we be of service? Before we speak of that, would I be correct in assuming that Mistress Waters is unfamiliar with our recent history? Then, with your permission, I shall recount the tale of her benefit. For her benefit. Woo. As you may know, Falcon's Nest was once a hamlet with a small garrison of knights and some few villagers, and then came the calamity. When it became clear that the snow would not stop falling, we had no choice but to order a complete withdrawal. The settlement and the entirety of the Western Highlands were to be abandoned. Abandoned to the heretics, Lady Iceheart and her kind have walked these lands with impunity ever since. Aye, but no longer. The Holy See has commanded the reclamation of the Western Highlands and the expulsion of heretical elements. Falcon's Nest is key to accomplishing these objectives, but, as you can see, rebuilding the hamlet will be no small undertaking. Our craftsmen require support and protection. Any assistance you can offer will be greatly appreciated. As promised, we have House Fortan, or you're at... As promised, we have House Fortan, or at your disposal, Sir Redwald. You need but tell us where to begin. A simple nod is more than enough to answer a simple question. Several craftsmen in service to House Zalmal are contributing to the restoration of Falcon's Nest. These men and women are quite skilled at building and repairing fortifications, but their progress has been hampered by a number of factors. Ralph, their foreman, tells me he has need of a woman with your talents. Would you be so kind as to seek him out? I found you. But how do I know it's you? Do you have names floating overhead? Yes, I'm Ralph. And who might you be? He's got some dark eyes. He could use some sleep. Ah, the promised help. Glad to have you aboard. I have the honor of overseeing this fine mess you see before you. Sent me over on one of them blackbirds, same as you, to build and mend and tell others how to build and mend. A fury take me. This ice is bloody unnatural how fast it forms. It's icicle sprites, I tell ya. Mark my words, there are pockets of them here and there, just waiting for me to turn my back so they can sneak out and do their dirty work. So I needed to search the hamlet and put an end to it. If you stay and watch long enough, you're sure to find them. We know what this dark matter means. Ah, now there's a woman what looks like she's found her marks. You're just the sort we need around here. The kind that'll hop to when she sees a task undone. You're a dab hand at Warcraft, I can tell. Not that I have any skill at arms to speak of mine, but it doesn't take an expert to recognize expertise. Be a waste to keep you to myself when there's others out there what need help same as me. So if you're keen to keep on doing what you've done, I'd ask you to head north to the pike. The bloody huge statue on the waste, if you've never been. Mason, by the name of Theramont, is out there tending to the thing. Good man, Theramont, but I reckon he's taken on too much work for one. Might be there's something you can do for him. I've been known to help build houses in my time alive. Go away, Deepi. I was enjoying the music until you interrupted. You sloth. Hail to you, traveler. What brings you out this way? Foreman Roth bid you assist me. Well, far be it from me to turn down a helping hand. I've been tasked with the restoration of this sculpture. 5 years of neglect have not been kind, to say the least. Fortunately, I've just a thing for it. Rather, those Deepis have it. If you could slay three and bring me their bristles, I would be in your debt. Now I can get my revenge on this one for disrupting the beautiful music. You punk. Hey, back! There you are. Have you the bristles? So Barg bristles, thick, deep gray bristles sheared from a wild beast, and it was beautiful. Ah, feel how coarse that is? That's why they're perfect for scrubbing the soot from the statue. Beautiful, isn't it? Oh yeah. The spitting image of Haldrath, first of the Azul Dragoons, and one of Ishgard's founding fathers. A symbol of everything the Dravanians despise, which is why they've taken to searing it with dragon fire every time they pass by. But no longer will we suffer this desecration of our nation's hero. Soon the statue will be as it once was, a proud, shining testament to the determination of Ishgard, and a message to the heretics that we have returned. The work may be hard, and the conditions harsh, but as a proud Ishgardian, I could ask for no greater honor. Are you for Falcon's Nest? If so, I have a favor to ask. There's this knight, Sir Saudor, woohoo, what a name, stationed at the Anvil to the west of here. She's always treated me with kindness and respect, more than I deserve, to be honest. Any road, while you're away, she came through on patrol, and I think she might have left a package behind. It's a bit of a detour, but would you mind returning it to her? My thanks to you, friend. Special livery. What's that? A package? I haven't the foggiest what you're talking about. Ice-crusted bundle. A once hot package unintentionally left by Isidore to core in the frigid Highland winds. Oops. Might be good. Confound it. That full of a... what a waste. It was a gift, adventurer. Thermont labors day and night without regard for his own well-being. At the very least, he ought to try to eat better. Why not simply give it to him? By the Fury, have you no sense of decorum? A high-born knight cannot be seen favoring a low-born mason in such a manner. Nevertheless, I appreciate your concern, as well as your willingness to assist Thermont. May your journey back to Falcon's Nest be safe and swift. Pray give my regards to Sir Redwald. Got so used to the quickness over in the other side that I feel so slow on my chocobo. I must applaud your initiative, Mistress Waters. Rolf tells me you've been quite busy. Alas, we have not the time to thank you properly. I have a task to which I would commit all able-bodied women, you and Lord Orterell included. Calm as ever, even when you must surely sense the gravity of the situation. A veteran through and through, just as Lord Drillmont said. Good. We have lost contact with a reconnaissance party sent north to Riversmeet in search of the heretic's hideaway. Whether they were attacked or met with some other misfortune, we know not. But regardless of the cause, we must act quickly, for this is a harsh, unforgiving land which can claim, and has claimed, the lives of many men. To ensure we find our missing knights as quickly as possible, I have assigned each party a different area to search. You and Lord Arterell will be working together. Seek him out when you are ready to depart, and good luck. Oh, but he's right here. It seems we have been assigned the area near Camp Riversmeet, Mistress Waters. Lest you are unaware, the camp was one of many our knights were forced to abandon when we withdrew from the Kirithus Western Highlands, one of many sacrifices made in the wake of the calamity. It would not surprise me if our knights took shelter there. There is but one way to find out, though. Let us be off. Let's be. There, below us, Camp Riversmeet, or what remains of it. I see no way to descend the cliffs safely from here. Should we fall, the beast below would make short work of us. Come, I know a path to the riverbed below, east of the Black Iron Bridge. Are you sure I can't just drop down? I know that I could. If the reconnaissance party came this way, I see no sign of it. Still, it is possible that recent storms have obscured their trail, or that they took an alternate route to Camp Riversmeet. Until we investigate the camp itself, we cannot be certain. We must press on. Are you alright? I heard sounds of a struggle. Thank the fury. I thought no one would come. Three heretics slain and one knight saved. Just like that. You certainly live up to your reputation, Mistress Waters. What happened here, sir? Is there no one else? We were caught in a furious blizzard north of here, my lord. Not but white all around, until we saw shapes moving towards us, running towards us with naked steel in their hands. I cut down a few of the bastards who came close, but the others, there was shouting and screaming, but after a while I could only hear unfamiliar voices. I found my way to the camp, hoping to hide while the storm passed. Well, the heretics tracked you here? My lord, the heretic's hideaway lies somewhere to the north. We must move quickly, before the snow bears all trace of their passing. For my brothers, we must... Have faith, sir. Justice will be done. But first, we must see you to safety. He has the right of it, Mistress Waters. Whatever remains of the heretic's trail will be gone with the next snowfall. But we cannot very well leave our friend here. I will see him to Falcon's Nest and gather reinforcements. In the meantime, I would have you search the area to the north of the camp for signs of the attack. Should you pick up the heretic's trail, do not wait for me. Follow it back to their lair forthwith, being sure to leave me some clear footprints. I realize that this plan may place you in considerable danger, but I see no alternative. Rest assured we will not be far behind, and Delara, thank you. I do have one question though. How are you going to know those are my tracks if you yourself said that my feet, that any tracks are going to get obscured in the snow? The tracks continue to the north. Thank you.
Looking for me, I presume?
Ah, the child who glimpsed the truth.
No, it cannot be.
She cameth unto me, as didst thou. Alike in gifts, yet set upon different paths.
He speaks true, Warrior of Light. Like you, I have been blessed with the Echo. The visions terrified me at first. They came without warning. I wondered what I had done to deserve them. But I had no time to ponder such things once the calamity came. The land turned against us, and in a matter of hours, Falcon's Nest was buried under 10 fulms of ice and snow. We had no choice but to flee for Ishgard. We came to the wall, and while we searched for a way through, there was an avalanche. And then I was alone. So I set forth for Dravania. I knew full well what might happen where I found, but I could not survive on my own. I was found, of course, and not by a mere dragon, but by the great worm, Hraesvelgr. And it was then that I knew why I had been given this gift. For with it, I heard his voice and saw the truth through his eyes. I was chosen to deliver this revelation to the people, to bring dragon and man together as they once were and should ever be. It wasn't supposed to be like that. You have to believe me. It was beyond my control. Children taught to fear the skies, who saw their loved ones slaughtered. Yet the Dravanians, though they know where the fault truly lies, fell upon them with such fury.
Men die, and their children forget. But we are everlasting. To us, then is as now. Thou canst not comprehend the violation, the outrage, the fury.
I will make this right. I am neither a saint nor a savior, just another sinner. Yet I will not forsake this cause. I cannot. I will see this cycle broken and peace restored. We can do naught else, for we are now as one.
Mistress Waters. Praise Helena, you are alive. We came as swiftly as we could, but I see we are too late. So they were lurking in the cell of this farmhouse. Tis a pity Lady Iceheart escaped, but we must not let that detract from your accomplishment. We have them on the run. You have dealt our foes a telling blow this eve, my friend, and I shall see that your efforts are recognized. Establishing an outpost in so remote a location could not have been easy. Tenacious devils. The knights have matters here well in hand. Let us return to Falcon's Nest and share our discoveries with Sir Redmold. Redmold? Come. After tracking heretics across mounds of ice and snow, I would say you are due a few hours rest next to a warm fire and maybe a cup of hot cocoa. Lord Orterell, Mistress Waters, full glad am I to see you both hale and healthy. What news? You mean to say you hunted the heretics down on your own and slew them before reinforcements could arrive? By the fury! I believe we have made great strides towards purging these lands of heretics, and I mean to say as much when I deliver my report to my father and the Holy See. As will I, Lord Orterell. May it serve to remind our superiors what houses Durindale and Fortan could achieve through continued cooperation. Indeed, I trust you and your knights are content to handle the rest. We most certainly are, my lord. During your short time with us, you and Mistress Waters have accomplished far more than I had thought possible, and I cannot in good conscience impose upon you any longer. Pray return to Ishgard with my thanks. As you wish, Sir Redwald. We thank you for your hospitality. Mistress Waters, I would speak plain. From the first I question your motives and your competence. Unjustly, I now realize. Rumors have a way of growing more fantastic as they spread, and quite frankly, those surrounding you beggar belief. Well, Hiroshifan swore that all the stories were true. He championed your cause and begged Father to grant you patronage. And he duly listened, because for all his wisdom, he has never been able to say no to my dear half-brother, the legacy of my father's sole indiscretion. Mother hated him, of course. Even on her deathbed, she refused to acknowledge him. And, to be honest, she was not alone in her feelings. But that is not the worst of it. At Camp Riversmeet, when we came upon the wounded knight, I knew immediately that one of us would have to pursue the heretics alone. An onerous task fraught with danger. And there you were, the savior of Eorzea, an honored guest of House Fortan, my new comrade-in-arms, Hiroshifal's dear friend. I told myself it was to be a test. Part of me hoped that you would fail. Yet you accepted the task without a word of protest, nor any sign of fear, and you duly tracked the enemy down, faced him alone, and lived to tell the tale. Plainly, Hiroshifan had the right of it all along, that I doubted your strength bespeaks mine own weakness. But I will not doubt you again, Mistress Waters. On that, you have my word. Ah, Mistress Waters, my lord the Count much desires to speak with you regarding your time with Lord Orital and Lord Ermanlian. If you would remain here for a moment.
The hero returns. I cannot thank you enough for saving young Emanalane's life. Aye, he told me everything. I've also received letters from both House Zamyle and Durindare, praising your conduct and that of House Fortong. You've won us much honor, my friend.
My lord.
What is it? Speak.
Pray forgive the intrusion, my lord, but I bring grave tidings. Master Alfino and Mistress Tataru have been detained on suspicion of fomenting heresy.
What? Explain.
They were observed entering a tavern in the lower levels on some half dozen occasions. There, it is claimed, they made a number of inquiries. Inquiries which brought them into contact with certain elements. T'was this which prompted a Knight of the Heaven's War to demand that they be questioned. Sir Grinnow, my lord.
Sir Grinnow is a brute. An exceedingly accomplished brute, but a brute nonetheless. Alas, he is also a son of House Zamayo. How quickly we forget the petty nature of men. I'd wager your friends are no more than pawns in another of my countrymen's games. Such is the way of things between the high houses.
Though you have won the hearts and minds of many of my countrymen, there are those who will never be swayed. Men who will dismiss your efforts and resent your successes, even as we celebrate them. 'Tis like that one such member of House Zermile is manipulating Sir Grinnow, for he is not a man to dabble in politics of his own volition. He may genuinely believe your friends be guilty, though I am quite certain his masters know better. Yet the truth will avail us naught if we cannot prove their innocence. You would do well to speak with Sir Emmerich at the congregation of our knights most heavenly. He would know more of these charges. I'm on your desk! It has been too long, Delara. Would that this visit came under happier circumstances. You are come to plead for Master Alfino and Mistress Ataru, I take it. What if the detainment reached us while I was delivering my report on the Vanu Primal? Truly, I know not which is the most ludicrous. These charges, or that flying feathered whale. That Sir Grinnow accusations are baseless, I have no doubt. Refuting them will be difficult, however, as he is a knight of the Heaven's Ward. I speak of the personal guard of the Archbishop, the 12 finest knights in all of Ishgard, sworn to serve his eminence alone. Suffice it to say, their testimony is unimpeachable, and have not the authority to challenge their actions. After all the signs I've done, routing the heretics and defeating Shiva, helping us to defend the steps of faith and drive back the Dravanian horde, after proving themselves true allies on countless occasions, is there not we can do? I feel there is but one path left to us. We must demand a trial by combat. But of course! In a trial by combat sanctioned by the Inquisition, the victor's claim is judged true regardless of the petitioner's standing. Under Ishgardian law, a trial by combat pits the accuser against the accused. In this instance, Master Alfino and Mistress Tataru would be expected to face Sir Grinnow and a second of his choosing. Another knight of the Heaven's War, most like. Two of them! By the fury, that can hardly be considered fair. Master Alfinode's magical talents will not have gone unnoticed, meaning that he will have no choice but to participate. Mistress Ataru, on the other hand, is quite obviously bereft of martial skill, and should be afforded the right to name a champion to fight in her stead. Lest you doubt, I am ready and willing to serve in this capacity, as I am sure as Lord Hiroshifan, but all here present know that you are the most accomplished warrior among us. And mayhap in the realm at large. Then it is settled. I will visit Master Alfano at once and inform him of our intentions. Dallara, meet me at the tribunal when you have made ready. Until then, my friend. Listen carefully, Dallara. When the trial begins, the petitioner will be asked to restate his charges, and the accused invited to respond. Then, in accordance with the law, they will be asked to restate their request for a trial by combat. Once the High Adjudicator acknowledges Mistress's Tataru right to name a champion, that is when you must make your entrance. Oh, and I cannot wait to see the look on Sir Grinno's face when he sees his true opponent. Will be priceless. More seriously, should you begin to lose heart, look to me in the stands, and I shall cheer so loud you will wonder how you could ever have contrived to doubt yourself. Now, are you ready? Kick some ass.
We are gathered here today under the watchful gaze of the Fury to ascertain the guilt of two souls in a trial by combat. Petitioners, step forward. Sir Grinno, for the benefit of all here present, I would ask you to repeat the charges which you have leveled against this man and this woman.
I, Sir Grinno de Zemile, brother of the Heaven's Ward, did bear witness to these two foreigners consorting with heretics.
Let the accused step forward. Alfino Leveilleur, Tataru Taru, you have heard the charges leveled against you. Will you take up arms to refute Sir Grinno's claim and thereby prove your innocence in the eyes of gods and men?
I, Alfino Leveilleur, am innocent of this charge and claim my right to trial by combat.
I, Tataru Taru, am innocent of this charge. But I am no warrior and cannot fight. So I claim the right to name a champion.
To the old and the infirm, the young and the weak, this right we allow. Very well. Who will stand for this woman?
Just as I was beginning to doubt the efficacy of the Ishgardian justice system. Come, my friend, let us put an end to this mummer's farce.
Render unto us your judgment. Raise up the righteous and cast down the wicked.
cry.
You now.
Down with you!
I mean, we won! The Fury has spoken. Afna Lavier, Tataru Taru, you are hereby acquitted of all charges. Blessed are we who have received her wisdom and see justice wrought by her divine hand. Petitioners, accused, go forth in peace. Delivered from an untimely demise yet again. My thanks as always. By the Fury, what a splendid victory! To see how you strove in the face of adversity. Two brave young souls bound together by the puissant bonds of camaraderie. Why, it stirred me to the very depths of my soul. Having been treated to such a rousing spectacle, it seems only right that I present you with a humble token of my admiration. Pray receive of me this chocobo whistle. With it, you may summon a black chocobo. Fully trained and ready to fly. A cute little bugger. Magnificent, is she not? Strong, yet sleek. Elegant, yet eager. What say you, Delara? Will you take her for your steed? Lord Hiroshifan, chocobos are prohibited in the Supreme Sacred Tribunal of Hellenic Inquisitory Doctrine. Your steed must remain outside. Come. Aw, man. Black chocobos are all well and good, but the true reward for your efforts is the exoneration of your comrades. They shall be released upon the completion of certain minor formalities, which I mean to see to personally. In the meantime, pray return to Fort Tim's Mana. The Corps has done so already, and will doubtless be eager to discuss the day's events. Helene smiles on us yet again, Mistress Waters, guiding you to victory and setting your comrades free. I confess, I did not fear for your safety. Which is not to say I doubted your prowess, you understand. I merely knew the strength of your opponents. You do have a habit of exceeding my expectations. Fasting to the heavens ward while the city's elite looked on? By the Fury! Anyone who hasn't been paying attention to you will surely do so from now on. My lord. We have just received a message from the vault. His Eminence, the Archbishop, requests the presence of Mistress Waters. An invitation from the Archbishop? What an honor. A personal summons is indeed a great honor, and given recent events, you would be wise not to delay. Go, Mistress Waters. We shall speak anon. A priest will be waiting for you outside the vault. Identify yourself to him and he will escort you inside. We are honored to receive you, Mistress Waters. This way, please.
Your Eminence, it is my honor to present to you the Warrior of Light.
I have heard the tales of your many grand endeavors. The Lord Commander has also been most effusive in his praise. I am Thordon the Seventh, Archbishop of the Ishgardian Orthodox Church, and I bade you come here that I might offer my personal apologies. You will forgive me for not calling upon you as courtesy would dictate, but as you can see, my more sprightly days are long behind me. But I digress. Your companions were wrongly accused of heresy and subjected to gross indignities. This, I am sorry to say, was the result of negligence on the part of our nation's protectors. Negligence born of an excess of zeal. Is that not so, Sir Zephyrin?
Yes, Your Eminence. Regrettably, it would appear that we of the Heaven's Ward were in receipt of erroneous information. Sir Grinnell has ever been headstrong. He pressed charges before the truth had been ascertained, for which I most sincerely apologize.
An unfortunate misunderstanding born of an earnest desire to serve Ishgard, but one which should never have occurred. For who could doubt the character of those who bested Shiva and drove the Horde from the steps of faith? Not I, that much is certain. That will be all, Sir Zephyrin. I would speak with our guest in private.
Your Eminence? As you wish, Your Eminence. That will be all for today.
Privacy is a luxury rarely afforded one in my position. Now tell me, young lady, what do you know of the Asians? Much and more, I shouldn't wonder, being the bringer of light. You should know that I myself have met with them, have entertained them as guests, even. Those harbingers of chaos and strife offered us power that we might continue our war against the dragons. I have no intention of aiding their cause, of course. Nor less of being their puppet. Yet, were I to refuse them outright, I should learn naught of their true objectives and remain powerless to stop them. Thus have I hearkened to their words with interest and paid lip service to their beliefs, biding my time and preparing for the inevitable conflict. And why do I tell you this? Because there is naught in this world they fear more than the power of the Warrior of Light. If we are to rid ourselves of these vile interlopers, we must needs work together. With our combined strength, I have faith that we can wrest Eorzea from their grasp and paved the way for a lasting peace. Think on it.
There you are! I confess, I was more than a little concerned when I learned that you had been summoned to the vault. What did they want with you? Well, well. A formal apology and an admonishment of those responsible. I see my fears were wholly misplaced. By the gods! The Archbishop freely admits to consorting with Ascians. So, their ambitions extend to Ishgard as well. We will have new primals to contend with ere long, of that you may be certain. Tis but a matter of time. Yet shorn of the support of our missing allies, what can we realistically hope to achieve?
Of all the excitement, I completely forgot to tell you. When I was asking around about the Scions, I heard the most awful rumor. General Rauburn is to be executed for crimes against the Sultanate!
If the Flame General dies, we will lose a staunch ally, and the one man capable of holding the Sultana's assassins to account. Lord Orshifon was wise to counsel restraint, but this business will brook no delay. We cannot permit this execution to take place. We must save Rauburn.
We will save him. Next time. We gotta save some things, and that's a good place to stop. Anyways, I hope you guys are enjoying yourselves. Take care.